like you. So God, in the house this morning, we all declare there's none like you, God. We tried, amen, things, God, but it couldn't do like nobody could do me like Jesus. And the people of God gave God a praise, amen, that he was pleased with. And the people of God offered to God a praise that heaven even, amen, opened up the windows of heaven and began to pour out on God. Say, amen, let's give God a hand of praise. And if you appreciate what God has done for you on this week, God bless you. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. 1 Timothy, amen, chapter 6. Amen. As God began to speak to me, amen, on this week, there's some things that he told me, amen. And he told me in secret to share with you openly. Amen. And God began to have he put something in my spirit that tickled me. He said, even the one that's paying that lottery, if I allow them to hit it, they ain't going to do me right anyway. But God told me that somebody is about to hit the lottery.
Oh, yeah, Lord.
The Bible said he always revealed unto the prophet. But listen what he told me to tell you. Hitting the lottery can get you in more trouble. Because money is a tool. And if you don't know how to use it right, it can kill you. He told me, he said, somebody is going to hit the lottery.
Amen.
He said, yeah, they're going to hit it. They've been playing it. You're the one, whoever played it, you're about to hit it.
All right.
Taking God's money, you're going to hit it. But I'm going to tell you what he told me again. It can get you in more trouble than what you're already in.
Right.
If you don't use it right. Now some of y'all looking at me funny. You know if you had money today, some of you probably wouldn't even be at church. You'd be on the cruise right now.
All right.
Now just be real. Some of you would be doing things. You would be doing things outside the norm because you're capable of doing it.
That's right. Amen.
Money is not evil, but the love of money. When you let the money rule you. And many of us, amen, ain't good with money.
All right.
Because money rules us.
Amen.
Many of us had good money in our hand at times. And we was poor management over.
Yes.
So I say, come on, say amen. Say, don't leave me out there.
Yes, sir.
I've known people that have been a part of my congregation has been millionaires and literally almost broke today.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't understand how can you have that kind of money in your hand as a Christian and not see right. Come on, say something to me now.
Amen.
And you study asking God to do greater things. And God said, wait a minute. He would allow things to come in your presence. He said, I set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. These things are set before us every day of our life. He said, but make a choice. And what is killing us today as Christians, we don't know how. Give him something. Take him to the back. Give him something. We don't know how. Okay, I'll talk to the preacher. We don't know how to govern our blessing.
Amen. Amen.
I told a guy the other day, promise is a process, but process comes with pain. And if you remember the praying when you get to the promise, you won't mess up the process. A lot of us didn't have no pain when we got to our promise. And that's why we went back to our problems.
Oh, amen.
When you experience pain with your promise, it'll make you appreciate your promise. It'll make you honor and respect it. Man, God, may God, you get that from me, and I'm not going to take that for granted. Thank you. I'm in the process of my life where I'm just regrouping on some things. One of the things the Lord told me is to continue to keep the house like you want the house to be kept. There's a spirit that has set up in the city of Corpus Christi. I told you when I flew back in. It's hovering over the city. People are not giving God what He deserves. This is supposed to be the body of Christ. A city where people come and receive blessings from God every day throughout the week. We have a lot of tourists, people that come to this city. A lot of people come down here to see Selena, but Selena ain't going to get you into heaven.
Amen.
But Jesus Christ is who you want to honor and give reverence to. Every morning you get up, you need to tell Him, Lord, thank you for another day.
Amen. Amen.
You may not like the day, what's going on in the day, but you ought to give God enough, have enough sense to say, Lord, thank you for the day. When I got up this morning, God took me to 1 Timothy chapter 6. And He told me to tell you these things today. I want everybody to repeat after me. Confident in Christ.
Confident in Christ.
Build true character in crisis.
In Christ.
Confident in Christ. Build true character in crisis. If you ever want to know who you are and who you really are, it's during crisis.
That's right.
You said it this morning, Houston probably the church is full,
mm-hmm.
but people are having a crisis right now.
Mm-hmm.
And they're making a lot of promises to God, like we will, if a storm comes. Lord, you get me out of this.
Yeah.
Your relationship with God should be built on Him just being God. Regardless of what's going on in your life, you should always say, Lord, I thank you because you God, and no matter what's going on in my life, you still in control. But some of us allow our character to change during crisis because we really show our true color. Anybody can believe God when the sun is shining.
All right.
Anybody can believe God when all roses are red and violets are blue. But when the thorns started sticking up.
Yes, sir. All right.
When your job tell you, I don't need you no more.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
When the person you've been in love with for all your life begin to act like they never loved you.
Yeah. Mm.
That's when you find out who you really are. Paul talked about something. And I got into, not a disuse, but I made a rebuke to God the other day. Let me get to the scripture. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 1. There's a bad spirit that have rose up in the land, and it's not only in the church, but it's on the job. Paul says in 1 Timothy chapter 6, he says, first of all, he says, it was a time where you got to be a slave to somebody. And they're going to say that right now. Many of us don't know how to be a slave to nothing. But you want to answer to somebody. And because you ain't in charge, you have no right to disrespect the master. And we'll rebuke some of y'all because y'all been on your job and you've just been aggravating and acting crazy with your leader. I don't care if they're the Ku Klux Klan.
You're right.
And you're supposed to be a Christian.
That's right.
Honor and respecting your leaders.
That's right.
And you try to use the Bible and scripture to rebuke somebody who's over you. Let me see what the scripture says. You don't believe me. That as many bond servants are under the yoke, count their own master worthy of all honor. You got to give honor where honor is due.
That's right.
If God wanted you to be the master, He would make you the master and somebody else the slave. But y'all better hear me this morning. Y'all need to go back to your job, and some of you need to repent because you're trying to make the boss the slave and you the master. And God rebuked me. He said, Terrell, until you sit in that seat, you have no reason to make any type of statement towards somebody in that seat. And then if I was a pastor, bishop, I was bishop, I wouldn't be there. That's why you ain't me. See, when you become me, then I'm going to sit over there and say, if I was me, I would do it different. Don't ever make a judgment towards somebody if you ain't never sat in that seat. Please, saints. That's one of the worst things you could ever do, is sit there in the stand and make a statement about something you ain't never experienced.
All right. Yeah.
I don't never tell my wife, look like you just got it easy because you're sitting at a desk. Because I know sitting at a desk ain't always sitting at a desk.
No,
you got to work with computer, you got to work with numbers, you got to type and grammar. Come on. And then some of us have went into places and, oh, you in an air conditioner. Well, I can't help it because I got air conditioned mind and you got heat mentality. You don't know what that person had to go through to get to that place. I honor what you guys do. So Paul says to them, he said, let them who their yoke count their own master worthy of all honor, so that the name of God, what's been made mockery of when we disrespect our master, we make the name of God look unprofitable. I never heard so many sinners talking about the saints. That's a Christian. Ain't working on time.
Huh.
They take extra 20-minute breaks.
Oh my.
But that's a Christian. That's a child of God.
Mm-hmm.
What church you go to? Well, I ain't got time to answer to the devil. Well, maybe you might be the devil today.
All right.
So that the name of God, you see what I'm saying? God, people don't even want to come no more because if Christians don't show up and work on time and they go to church and get the Holy Ghost and God anoint them, why should I go? There's no evidence. There's no examples no more. There's no people want to live right because many of us are not doing right.
All right. That's right. That's good.
What the Bible says. Paul says that not only the name of God and His doctrine, which is the Word of God, may not what? Be blasphemed. People make it fun. Oh man, ain't angel. And you might well take that fish off the back of your trunk, man. You cut the water what I. Sometimes I have to catch myself and remind myself who I'm representing.
Amen.
See, y'all didn't say amen to that.
Yeah.
I have to catch myself because I'm a failure. I'm going to fail.
Amen.
And remind myself who I am representing.
Right.
Because the Bible says any man in Christ Jesus is what? A new creature. In who? In Christ. And that's what I said. Confidence in Christ. When you fail, tell the Lord, Lord, I need you to hurry up and get back at me. I'm making a mockery of you because I'm proclaiming that I'm a part of you. But right now, God, it's more of me and less of you. And those who have believing master, let them not despise them because they are our brother. Here we go again. Some of you think you got favor because your leader is a Christian. Well, you know, we know that what the Lord say, favor ain't fair. Yeah, but the clock ain't got nothing to do with favor.
That's right.
And the first thing, see, that we want to do when we find out somebody or brother, see, a Christian on our job, first thing we want to do, praise the Lord, man. What the Lord saying? Get to work on time.
Mm-hmm.
Do your job. All
right.
My boss was a Christian. But your boss is still a boss.
That's right.
One thing God told me, he says, when you go into leadership, you have to change your character.
That's right.
And sometimes in changing your character, you have to change the crowd you hang around with.
Yes, you do.
Amen.
Come on, y'all been in the military. Hey, that's why I say fraternization. You can't, a chief can't hang with a PO3.
Mm-hmm.
PO3 out there dropping his pants, shaking all out in the field.
Mm-hmm.
And you supposed to be a leader?
Mm-hmm.
Then he get back to work on Monday and say, man, you can't tell me nothing. You was in the club dancing with me.
That's right.
Look at somebody say, it's time for separation.
Separation.
See, you want promotion, but promotion brings many things that mean that you have to reprioritize things, woman of God.
Mm-hmm.
That's the thing. Some of us, amen, wonder why when God began to bless us in the anointed, why we felt funny around certain people. Because some people did not promote with you. They still in the same mentality. You can't be in the promised land with a wilderness mentality.
Amen.
Y'all clap your hands and say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Now, you don't need approval of people for their blessings. Because some first they didn't want to say, I don't want to pray for you to get there. But you might have prayed for them to get there, but you ain't in the boat running the boat. And that's another thing that demon in the lane. You would have never got it was for me. Well, is that true?
Oh, my.
You think so?
Yeah.
Come on, then.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
This was a part of God's plan. Matter of fact, I might have got it early if I would have just been praying with some people that was going to pray with me.
Uh-huh.
Some people just really don't want you to be with us. You know, some people that don't really want you to ever get married so you can just go on and they husband have to answer the door and you don't have to answer no more.
Mm-hmm.
They like you because you sing. Well, I call sister, she ain't got nothing to do. Let your husband answer the phone. What you want today? Some people don't never want you to grow out of things because they want to attach themselves to you for the rest of the world. Y'all ain't saying that. Y'all might well clap your hands today.
Amen. Amen.
But rather serve them because those who are benefits are believers and beloved. Teach and exhort these things. Listen, because I'm going to teach what they strategy to always say. Boy, he was an army, true born soldier. Boy, he'd get mad on Wednesday night when the Saints wouldn't show up on time. Because he comes straight from the recruiting in uniform. He'd be hot too. Keep teaching, Bishop. Somebody show up the back door. He'd be out there rebuking. How can I be at a recruiting all day long? How can I be at the recruiting station? And I can't, what's your problem, sir? Man, let me pray for you right now.
Because
this is a disgrace.
All right.
When you come in and you dishonor God like this. See, sister T, we don't have faiths like that no more. We have faiths go home and talk about you. We don't have faiths rebuke you in person no more. When I was coming up, them faiths would rebuke you on the spot.
All right.
Sister, what you got on? Well, you need some dressing. We're going to go out to church and get you some. Because you don't need to come in here like that no more.
All right.
And bring that spirit in.
All right.
They was really being honest. They didn't rebuke you and then left you hanging out the door. Say, don't y'all forget, when y'all see somebody coming going through some things, don't embarrass them. Pull them to the side. Show them some love. Then go get them some num-num. Say amen.
Amen.
You don't know what people have been through.
That's right.
He says, error and greed. Now, this is what I want to talk about. He says, anyone teach otherwise and does not consent to the wholesome word. We got a lot of people nowadays are not going with the word of God. We got people that is making up their own doctrine. Y'all know I'm telling the truth. Churches, it's okay to be homosexual.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have it.
Mm-hmm. Ministers that open it up.
That's right.
And just come the way you are. And then we got men hugging men in church.
That's
and
right.
That's just honor to God. Women's hugging women. Because God loves us. Yeah, God loves us, but the sin is a mockery before
that's
God.
That's right. Right. Amen.
Brother, when you know the truth, when you know the speed limit, what you doing breaking? And then when the police pull you over, first thing you going to do, what you pull me over for? You broke the limit. Don't you know when you drive a car, obviously you got a license to drive it, and you had to go take a test. And on the test, it told you the speed limit, so what you speeding for? Then y'all quiet. Y'all looking at me like I'm crazy. Wholesome truth. Well, and we up here arguing with the police when we know the law.
Well, yeah.
You don't like, you pull me over. I ain't pull you over because you were driving a night car. I pull you over because you were speeding.
Yeah.
Reckless driving. Breaking the law. And then sometimes they do put you off because you look pretty good. Don't feed me a bunch. Feed me God. Feed me truth. He said, for even the word of God, our Lord Jesus Christ, into the doctrine which is according with godliness. Everything in God's word will come out godliness. You can't take the word of God and work it for ungodliness.
Amen. Amen.
Anytime I counsel with anybody, I deal with anything, first I ask them, what did you do?
No.
Because God is the author of confusion. What did you do to get to this point? What did you do to pull you out of character if God is in you?
Well, I let the devil work. Okay, I'm glad you're going to confess it, so now we can work with the devil.
Yeah.
But don't act like God made you do this.
Huh.
God ain't going to never make you do anything opposite to the word of God. Y'all can hear me say it.
Yeah.
God ain't going to make you hit nobody in the mouth.
All right.
Christ is here. And not having God in your character will make you pull up.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all praying with me? So I got, every morning I'm adjusting my character to God's word. I get up in the morning. Sometimes you get up. How many get up sometimes you didn't have a bad day?
Mm-hmm.
You know it's already a bad day because you get up crooked. And the first thing you need to do on the way to work, repent.
All right.
God, I got a foul spirit in me. I didn't speak good last night. You know. I want to walk in this job and bring a bad reputation upon you.
Uh-huh.
So God, I repent. Help me. God, understand that? Sometimes you peel up, you get a crookie in there. You don't sleep good. But God is still God. That don't mean you have to go to work and blame the crook in the neck the way you're going to have, oh, I got a crook in my neck. And you're going to look at me funny today. I didn't have a good night. I argued with my husband last night. I want the devil to say something immediately. I've been up all night fighting. I'm ready to fight. What do they have to do with this being Tuesday when we got to move the lawnmower to the other side? And saints of God is negative and very bad at blaming their own situation on how they should act as a Christian. I'd rather somebody come in and say, y'all better pray for me today. I'm getting this corner. I've got some stuff going on. Now, God is still good.
Still good.
But I got issues.
That's right.
Now, you can't judge me. You're supposed to pray for me.
That's right.
You don't supposed to be over there trying to act like you ain't never done nothing.
Yeah, all right. That's right.
But sometimes when I see, you know, the first lady having a bad day or something,
mm-hmm.
I just go outside and start praying for her. I really do. I used to get in there, all, what you looking like that for? You ain't happy here? You know, we get into all this old fleshly office. You act like I did something wrong. You might not have did nothing wrong. She just,
right.
Her foot might be hurting.
That's right.
And here you go, getting that spirit get in you, and now the whole house, the dog is mad, the baby
right.
Is crying. What's all right.
Amen? All right, amen.
Everybody's out of character.
Yes,
and then company come over, they can smell when your house ain't right. Because you looking funny, the door halfway closed, the stream door ain't open up, character, just your character.
Right.
Character leaves.
Amen.
Character always leaves something back that ain't right.
Yeah.
The dog used to like you. He's growling at you. You're like, you don't know who I am? Today? No. Do you know when you change, everybody who's a part of you is affected by that change? Do you know that? Women to God, do you know that when you get mad at the husband, the kids get out of whack? Do you know that? Do you know, man of God, when you get mad at the woman of God and you decide that you ain't going to give her no more num-num, everybody suffers. Do you know that?
Yeah.
Because your character is you. And if you mess up, everything around you is going to be affected.
All
say
right.
Amen.
Amen.
But confident in Christ, what Paul said. He said, who does it? He is proud knowing nothing. A person who goes out and use the word of God as error, he is proud knowing nothing but is upset with dispute, argument over words. When you find a person that can't never reach a conclusion, that is a person of confusion.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Arguing every day is not the will of God.
That's right.
An argumental person is a person that is not, that have character issues in their life.
We all ain't saying that.
Can't never have a decent conversation.
We're going to go to the park.
Well, I don't like that park. It's the park.
Go to the other one.
It's too crowded here.
Okay. Right through your house.
Huh. Well, you don't want to take me to the park? I just took you to two of them. Obviously, it ain't the park today. It's you. We need to park the car and talk to you.
That's right.
Because we might go in the park and get in the drive-by because of your attitude. Because somebody at the park waiting for somebody like you, off mental. And you go over there. The Bible said that person is dispute, argument over word from which comes even. So anytime you find a person that is very off, y'all can write this down now. That person, something wrong with that person. Nothing's never right.
Can't hear Quentin. I must be preaching. I ain't hearing no pins in here.
Argument over words.
That ain't what the Bible said. Well, tell me what it said. Let's have Bible study. All right.
That's
not Bible argument. That's not Bible study. Quit arguing over the word of God. Quit getting at home trying to rebuke somebody. God don't want you arguing over scripture. Sit down and talk about it.
That's right.
Let's sit down and get in the word of God.
That's right.
Maybe I error. What did it say?
That's right.
The Bible says, that you love me. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, go up a little bit further. What does the Bible tell you to do? See, I read the scripture too. Don't just go pick out what you want to read. Have your script.
Yeah.
Read the whole chapter.
That's right.
Augmental.
People are full of envy. They are full of strife.
Yes, sir.
And they are very suspicious people. We have a lady in our neighborhood we used to call her Under Eye. Because she used to always look one eye open, but the other one looking like she. What y'all doing in the yard? We want to play. Get out the yard. Well, we ain't doing nothing but playing. Don't touch my grass. Evil old woman. Then we used to think she would put something on her, because all we walk past the house, all our back was starting to hurt. And we would think she was working witchcraft. Y'all had one of them in y'all neighborhood?
All
y'all
right.
Know what I'm talking about. Evil. Could never do nothing right. I said, Lord, when I grow up, I don't want to be like this. I don't want people to look at me. You ever had a grown up that you look at and you were scared of them? Because they were so evil.
Huh.
You didn't want to go to their house. Your kids will tell you when they're evil. You get to the door, I don't want to stay here. No. What's wrong with them? They ask nice, come over here and sit down. Mama Lee, set your crazy self down.
Okay.
You better not jump on my couch. I want you to jump today. Your mama ain't going to beat you, so I'm going to beat you. She don't know how to do it. Y'all ain't there. Some guys have had a flat tire. Oh, that'd be never mind. You ain't going to jump on this couch. I want you to jump. But you always want to act like you're hungry. Go in there and eat that food. I don't like it. You gonna eat it. Y'all remember them days? You gonna eat that food. Quick run over somebody's house acting like you want. Your mama got you going to McDonald's all the time. You gonna eat more than McDonald's. That's why you always constantly gonna make them eat. Get them greens. Eat them!
All right.
Remember? Make you eat that cornbread. That little time spending those $15 on you every time we go to the restaurant. You want to supersize your fries. You better eat it. I'm going to come back and check on it. Ain't my eat ready? And me eat that okra. I'll say, eat it! And every time I cry, she will whack me. Want to drink all the Pepsi, but you don't want to eat no okra. We need some more safety like that. And that's why we walk around. And really, that food, how many people do we done? Healthy food, green, beans, cornbread, tater.
Huh.
That's why we broke. We run into McDonald's through the drive-thru. And all you gotta do is just go down to ATB and just y'all gonna leave me out here today. Y'all gonna leave me out here today. Boy, y'all gonna leave me out here. All you gotta do is go down there and get some taters and greens and that cornbread and swirl that belly up and they'll be out in about 5 minutes. That McDonald's will have hyper high cholesterol. They're jumping over everything and seeing double stuff. And all night long,
long they just got didn't get there. I'm feeling sick. I would too if I eat a supersized fries and go sit in the sun for about 15 minutes. Shame, man. That don't match up. Sun and grease don't match up. Oh, boxer, grease, and then sit on the sun. I'm like about to pass out. I would too.
Amen.
Grease is cooking on top of your brain. Do you know when you eat them French fries from Amen McDonald's, they cook it. Just watch how they cook it. They cook it in a big lard of grease. That is going in your body. And when you get out in the sun, you might as well beat some eggs and put it on top of your head. It will cook you. That's what high cholesterol comes from. Say amen.
Amen.
Our kids is off. Go take them kids to the doctor. Their heart is clogged up already. Already clogged up because we feed them. We don't sit down and say, today we're going to go home. You're going to wait till I get through cooking. Clean that room up, Dad. My mommy said, clean it up.
Amen.
You come to the table hungry, walking sideways, you'd be glad to see that food.
That's right. That's
kids
right.
Nowadays, ungrateful.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I ain't going to eat that. I'm going to wait till y'all cook me some popcorn. You get some popcorn out of that. And that spirit comes to church. Order. Using rally of minds of corruption minds and dispute of truth. Suppose that God is a mean game. Oh, I'm going to go to church there. I might get a blessing. You going to church because I told you to go to church. Don't come try to bargain with God. Don't come up here and think you're going to gamble with God this week. Oh, yeah, I ain't saying nothing. Well, I'm going to go to church today because I just want to really do something real great this week. You ought to do something great because it's the right thing to do.
That's right.
Because it may not be a great week for you.
Right.
It might be a testing week for you. But if you got God in your life, you get up and say, you know what, Lord? You know what? I don't know. Do we know what's going to happen tomorrow? None of us do, right? We don't even know what's going to happen in the next Sunday,
right?
We don't even know what's going to happen in the next service. Do we know?
That's
we don't know, saints. But if we trust God, whatever come our way, we tell the Lord, Lord, I guess you brought me to it. You bring me to it.
All right. Amen.
And quit getting depression mixed up with despair.
All right.
Depression is you looking at the situation.
Yes, sir.
From your standpoint, giving God your assessment. Well, I guess it's meant for me to just jump on off the bridge. Depression. Despair says, God, you told me that I'm going to have many afflictions.
All right.
But you told me you won't leave me.
All right.
Come on, tell the Lord thank you.
Amen.
I got mad when we kept me about 5 minutes, honey. I got mad when Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego was in the fire and they were walking around the fire and fooling around and say, if he don't deliver us out of it, we know he's still able.
All right.
We even though he's in the fire with us, he don't have to get us out the fire because some of us are more better, us more proud in the fire than we are out the fire. I said, God, why did they weren't celebrating getting out the fire? Because God said they were safer in the fire. Some of you are safer where you at because you would never pray if you wouldn't go through. Come on, say amen. How do you God got you in that situation? Amen. Because you didn't know how to pray. And the fire ain't to protect your integrity. The fire is to build your character. God don't have to put you in no fire to find out how much you love. You were put in the fire to test your character. Shadrach and Meshach could have just broke down and said, you know what? Are we going to serve you, God? Is where you going to take us at? You going to make us, then you going to turn up 7 times high?
Nah.
You don't love me, God?
Right.
Shadrach looking like, man, I pay my tithe. Why are we in the fire? Is it getting hot to you, brother? It seems like it's not getting cooler. It's getting hot.
Uh-huh.
Oh, boy, I wish I had a glory to God. You know what I'm talking about.
That's true.
Come on now, God. Where you at?
That's right. That's good.
Now, what's everything break? Why is my car breaking down, God? Why is things happening to me? God say, why not you? Ha! Glory! Is the servant greater than the master? How do you say for better or worse the sickness?
Yes, sir.
Quit playing Monopoly with God.
I'm getting a tie. Maybe I get a ship to roll in.
No, you might get a submarine coming. You pay your tithe because you love God. You pay your tithe in crisis, in out of crisis. You pay your tithe. You go to work because you got a job. Oh, it's Good Friday. I'm going today. Oh, y'all got, some of y'all know what I do. I'm going to work Monday. I ain't going. Some of you already made your mind. You ain't going on Monday.
All right.
Come on, I'm going to take off the game. And if the game lose, I ain't going in. Ah! Oh, this boy preaching today.
Yes, sir.
Character change.
Amen.
Both men already know because Friday you was bragging before. Yeah, Cleveland going to beat the Warriors. Then you don't show up on Monday because you didn't bet somebody that lost.
Oh,
lost your rent money. Side man, now you're looking crazy.
All right. Now.
Come in on Tuesday asking for overtime. Because you done ran out of time.
Yeah.
Lord help us. Somebody say, Lord help me. Get away from them people who are always trying to use a scam to do a game.
Right.
Paul tell Timothy, withdraw yourself from them. I had a friend who was a gambler. That boy was dangerous. Huh. A gambler is a dangerous person. Because they do anything. Think about it. They don't care. That's why they gamble. That's why they're a gambler. They take a chance. Well, what is the chances of us getting busted? 1%, that's what someone might get you.
Yes, sir.
I was in school up there. The guy called it mid-Wednesday. They get to celebrate, man of God, midweek. They thought they had way through, but I know Wednesday is the day that you really got to press yourself down when you're in the midst of something.
All right.
Well, chap, we going to go out tonight because we halfway through. I said, yeah. Y'all been celebrating. Y'all early celebrating. We still got a test and we got 3 more days of projects to go. I'm withdrawing myself from y'all.
All right. Good.
Because you trying to get me to flunk and I didn't trying to get a flunk this time.
Yeah.
The Bible says withdraw yourself from people who likes to play Russian roulette. Look at the scripture. Paul said, game, always trying to get over on God, always trying to run his scam. One time, you happy when things going good? Now, godliness with contentment is what? Not just gain, what? When you are really a godly person, it'll teach you how to be content. And in contentment comes great gain. Mm. And y'all ain't gonna say amen there. I'm gonna show you what I mean by that. Why you looking funny? If God is in me, now in godliness, I'm already saved, I'm a godly person. When crisis comes, situations come in my life, it's going to teach me because God has come with contentment, which will give us great gain. Now watch this. You don't get contentment without God. Because you'll be impatient. Ungodly people are the most impatient people in the world.
Alright.
You ever see him at the light? And go! Get you killed.
Alright.
Always in a hurry and ain't going nowhere. Rushing you, but ain't going nowhere.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. You don't rush me. We're going to leave 15 minutes time so we won't kill nobody in the process going to get our game.
Huh.
Unworthy people wait 2 minutes out to try to beat success. Listen, get up in the morning. What time are you supposed to be at work? Get there. What is the rule of thumb? Give yourself 15, 20 minutes. 5 minutes in case the light ain't working right. Three other men, in case you see somebody on the side that need help that you know, you can just stop and tell them, I'll call 911 for you. I got to make it to work. God bless you.
Oh, God.
Y'all don't like that, but you know what? God wants you sometimes to just tell people, I see you. I'll call back. One time, one dude just blew the horn at me. Called me back on the phone. I see you, Rhea. You need to call somebody now. I'm trying to make it to work. I said, man, just thank you for blowing your horn, man. Look, some people passed by like they didn't know who I was. He too. Threw dice up too. I'll let you, dog. Trying to make it to work. He called me on the phone. But I was getting mad. I said, hey, how you going to do that? He said, man, I got to make it work, Rhea. I said, how am I going to get mad at somebody who's going to blow at me and they going doing the right thing? See, you got some people like, oh, that ain't nothing but the devil. No, I ain't the devil. You the devil. Well, getting out there 5 minutes and rushing and your tie blew out, you should check your tie. Go on, go out there, check your ties in the deep church. Check your tie. Say amen. Don't get on the highway with a bad tie. And you get mad, he ain't answering your phone. I had a flat. I had one too, but I got mine fixed. Say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Well,
Lord Jesus.
Can you still keep your religion in the midst of crisis?
Oh,
come on, say it. No, folks, right. I know I got good religion. I know I got good religion. They almost said, I know I got good religion. Oh, I got it. In my mind. They say, no, so I said, mama, they went up there. My daddy was there fucking with my mama and trying to get her to come out of carrot. I ain't gonna let nobody turn me around. Y'all know them old songs? I'm not gonna let nobody, oh, turn me around.
Amen.
My dad said, I'm gonna turn you. You're gonna fix that food on time. I come to fun. Hallelujah! Wow, that woman was saying in the midst of crisis. Where I started from.
Yes,
maybe you want some extra shot on it. I come to fun. I used to see my mama do it. My daddy said, you don't have to say when you cook my food. God is good. All the time. I'm still cooking your food. You the one that's going to have the crisis. Because other folks is cracking in the midst of crisis, don't you? Let me look at this last scripture. This is what got me, Sister Stewart. And I want y'all gonna get tick on me. I told Napoleon to come to church this morning. The Bible says a righteous man, and watch this man of God, a righteous man leaves an inheritance for his children. Now watch this.
That's right.
Where did the inheritance come from? From us working
mm-hmm.
while we was in this life
mm-hmm.
trying to achieve something that at the end somebody else gonna enjoy. Boy,
right.
Y'all, I ain't caught that today. Mm-hmm. We out there killing ourselves.
Yes.
Did you just catch that?
Yes.
You gotta catch this one. No, you didn't catch it. You gotta catch it. We work all our life.
All day long.
Just to go back to the dirt where we come from.
Somebody else going.
And you call it. Somebody else.
Wallow in my
Now go back to the previous chapter. Godliness with contentment and great gain. Mm-hmm. I'm going to enjoy my stuff.
That's right. Well,
let me get about it, y'all.
Right.
I'm going to enjoy my stuff, and all is going to be left over. Y'all ain't saying nothing to him. I'm going to enjoy what God has blessed me with.
Right.
I'm going to rest with the things that God has given me. You can have leftovers, not least.
That's right.
All right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Clarified, man, to go to the next scripture. And I'm leaving with it. For we brought nothing. What came in here butt naked? What? She hear amen, Grandpa. What came in here? No clothes on. I didn't see her. She had nothing on. I wasn't up there, but when I got watch it. I didn't come in here with no Tommy Hill figures on, no shoes on.
Right.
I came here with zero on.
Zero.
I owe y'all nothing.
Yeah.
Amen.
She's already a daddy. She ain't been here 6 8 months.
Because he already tell her, I'm going to whoop you up on top of that. She said, I didn't ask you to come here. Now how are we going to beat y'all when y'all didn't ask to come here? Watch this. Watch what Paul said. He said, I didn't pay nothing in this world.
Yeah.
Why are you worried about something you can't take with you when you die?
That's right.
Some of us are stressing out right now over stuff that we have accumulated.
Yeah.
On our own.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
Don't blame your extra bills on me.
All right. Amen.
I didn't tell you to go get that discount card. I didn't tell you to buy that house with extra pool.
Yeah.
I didn't tell you to buy that car that requires super prima. You wanted that. So be content with it. Shut your mouth up and quit. Oh, you know what? Yeah, I gotta go get this high gas. Well, it's part of the car walk. That's better than me.
Man, you don't know what I've been through, brother.
Well, no, I don't know what it's like to live in a $2.5 million house. Mm-hmm. But I probably wouldn't have went over there if I was going to be over there complaining. You know, when a realtor asks you what kind of house you wanted.
Uh-huh.
All right.
You could have got it. Just a normal house. We are now, I won't fit.
Yes.
It comes with something. Look at somebody say, it comes with something. Y'all just thought y'all just gonna have that baby. And that was gonna be it. Daycare. Milk. May the Lord watch between me and you while we're matching for one another.
Alright.
See, y'all looking at me funny. Sean didn't have to. Sean's stress right now is Sean's game stress. That's why when my kid called me, Dad, I'm going through my bill. I said, oh, yeah. I know what it's like when you want to move out of Dad's house and have your own house. Guess what, partner? You got to gain some stuff. You gain an electric bill. You gain a water bill. You gain my... Oh, talk back to me, somebody.
That's right.
Now pay for your bill.
That's right.
See?
That's right.
If I go tomorrow and buy a Bentley and Sean said, well, Dad, every time I turn around, man, I gotta take you to the shop, man, call me $200, change the sparkler. Dad, why did you buy a Bentley if you're gonna be complaining?
All right, amen.
I brought nothing into this world. I'm leaving you with this. If I died in the next 10 minutes, I have no authority over it. And the first lady going to have a garage sale. I already know. Because my stuff, she don't like having stuff like that. Because that's my stuff. Somehow to her, I probably don't start getting the stuff out of her. That's what I was saying, man. And you should sit up there acting like you ain't sitting up there. You may come know what I'm talking about. Brother Rand, you going to do, I don't like them. I never did like them anyway. You come get them for about $10. Man, Brother Rand, pay $6. I don't care. Get them out of here. Everything going to be for $3. Catch a sale. I've already experienced when I go on trips. She took up my house and throw my stuff away. I found out in the garage. I'm like, God, this is brand new stuff. I'm already experienced what it's like to be a dead man in my house. What am I doing? She take my stuff and throw it away. I'm like, no, I don't care if I got a 60 pair of pants. I know where they is. They was in the way. Your shoes in the way, but let me go home and just have a garage sale and sell all your jewelry. We've had this conversation. So I don't get mad. I just tell her, babe, you might want to see what it's worth before you just start moving stuff. You know, because you know when people die, you just get, like I told my wife the other day, I said, my dad had a lot of stuff. And the only thing I got was, my dad had a lot of jewelry. My dad had a lot of stuff. I ain't got nothing but a Cadillac was causing me to keep it short. That's just real talk. I love my dad. I mean, I wasn't talking to him on his deathbed about what the will was, but I know my dad left me more than just a Cadillac with the bills. I know he had to leave me something if I was alive. Maybe I'm going crazy. That got to be a problem here. But, you know, I ain't asked nobody because I got my own. I mean, you know, really, I didn't want to bring the Cadillac back because I ain't had nowhere to put it.
All right.
But they were about to rob and take the wheels off of me, and that was the only wheel he left me. So I had to figure out, I got to get this Cadillac out of here. But it's costing me.
All right. Oh,
never. I started talking to my dad, that ain't a problem. You said ain't a wheel? It's a problem. A wheel is something that you can enjoy. This is costing me.
All right. Amen.
Everyone got the nerve to got to keep it in the family. Won't you start paying for storage then? You know what I'm saying? You want to keep it in the family because you want it. But I'm the one paying for the store. A wheel is something meant for you to enjoy,
right,
and it brings an inheritance to your life.
That's right.
You leave me. And then all these bill collectors call me. You leave, brother. I left you $100, but you $200,000 in debt. I would not leave my family like that because you know what? That ain't an inheritance.
Amen.
That's a headache. I'm a priest there. That's wrong.
Amen. Amen.
Well, at least you got a house. It ain't a house. When you debt free, you when I'm just not saying it because I hope the first day don't have a flip, no idea try to knock me out because it ain't gonna work if God is with me. But I ain't afraid to tell my wife, really. I ain't. Some men say I'm scared to tell them. I tell them I'm gonna insure my wife. Don't she gonna be? Y'all ain't got to worry about it. Y'all ain't gonna put her on the street. Y'all ain't gonna be like we don't like you, first lady. You don't have to like her. My bishop wife passed. They kicked her out. She was out the church the night after. They didn't like her. So I got it right now where y'all don't like me, y'all don't worry about it. First lady gonna be all right.
Amen.
Cause we do know people change when people die.
Yes.
So y'all don't have to worry.
Right.
Kudos, love you. Now I hope the same thing with me, cause something happened to her and I'm walking around looking. I need some help. Y'all see? Look at somebody that loves a two-way street.
That's
love ain't just a one-way street. Go get you some insurance on you. Can't you kick over? I come in here and grin, and I miss it. Be crying, oh Lord, precious Lord, oh Lord. They look at me, Daddy, we gonna still be able to eat? Yeah, but Mama, that's a little good, son. Matter of fact, ain't no more cooking, but we gonna get a maid.
Ah.
Be at all your games. We gonna be able to work out all the time. Man, I miss it, Mama. You miss it, I miss it too. Mama. It's good talk. Everything that you accumulated in your life, when you leave here today, quit blaming your bills on somebody else to change your character. I'm mad because I'm in debt. You mad because you made a choice. Now look what he said. I brought nothing in, and having food and clothes, with these things shall be content. You know the only thing I owe Jay right now? You go in Jay's room, Jay got enough shoes. Y'all looking at me crazy. Y'all, I'm confessing it's good for the soul. I don't want you to come over my house and trip over something and act like I didn't care. But I'm telling you, the boy got enough shoes. You know what he'll do? I take him to school every day. He come out with the same shoes on every day. I'm looking like, he's like, I'm crazy. Why is he wearing? He got 10 shoes in 10 days. Why is he wearing the same ragged shoes every day? You ever had that problem with kids? You just, oh, they come out the house and you're like, let me tell you what they're doing. Let me tell you the trick. Y'all listen to me. What they like to do, they like to go to the store and look for them to buy them something. Y'all ready to go home? They like the stove to run. Because you're in the stove and you look down and you're like, man, I could swap off because you get mixed up. And they in the store with these hot water pants on. And you're like, man, you see, they reverse his psychology. So what my mama used to do, she used to whoop her. You gonna go out the house, you better look right. So when she go in the store, when everybody else buying stuff for their kids, we over there looking good. My mama sitting there saying, they don't need nothing to look at. That's the old trick in the book. But he tried to come out the house on me like that the other day. I said, I'm gonna give you two steps, and I'm going to I'm gonna beat you with the shoes out. Come on, I know it's the old kid. See, I raised up three. Ron used to do that. Ron, he's been in. Ron used to do that. Ron go. Ron have 100 pairs. Go out with me, and then he won't call him and say, "Hey, just do that." I said, "Ron, Come on, man. What are you guys doing? So when he dressed up a little nice, I said, Jay, now come on, man. Now you're making me feel like I know where my money went. Because, you know, when you go look at your account and you say, man, where did my money go? I'm ragged, but I ain't got no money. You know where your money went? You let them kids take you out of contentment and put you in confusion. Kids will take you out of contentment and put you in confusion. Now you're arguing with the man. I can't get my hair done. Baby, I gave you $200-some. What'd you do? Well, I was in the store and had to. Listen, did Johnny need them extra shorts? No, but babe, I just wanted him to be a happy kid. He's going to be a happy kid with holy shorts. No, I'm out of here. You know what? The Bible says a man rather be on the housetop than be in a condition. You know what? I'm out of here. Oh, y'all, I'm out of here. I'm going to get me something to drink. I'm gone. Y'all crazy. Y'all just took me off. I'm out of here. I'm going to the roof. What daddy had? He on the roof. Drink it. Drove him to drink. He's out there drinking. Drunk as a skunk. He said, I'm going to get drunk because if I go in the house, I'm going to kill somebody right now. Y'all ready to go home? Y'all know I'm telling the truth.
Amen.
People character change because you break them down, man, in the midst of character. That crisis bring people down. People crisis will make a man who was nice go crazy. You're like, why he mad? That dude was just grinning a few minutes ago when his check came in. But we got to looking at all these bills, anybody would lose their mind who goes to work, get paid on Friday, broke on Saturday morning, and can't do nothing on Sunday. Stop it, Sam. We're on our way to Chicago. You ain't got to go live in the bed. But if you say to all your sisters, I'm going to enjoy my trip. I'm going to get in that state. Somebody's in that table looking at you like, you going to share it? No. You don't have to be guilty over somebody else's
failure.
Say, stop doing that.
Amen.
I'm done. I went home. I didn't have nothing. So, just give Jay this prop. Yesterday, you that same in Bishop meeting ago, and sister going to talk about her sister's shoes, and I'm going to tell it. But yesterday, we was at Bishop, and you know, Jay got to the point now, he's a weekend traveler basketball player. Let me tell you what it's called. Now, I raised three boys. It calls him to get in. It's like we're going to watch him. But you know, we used to go to the boys' club, they watch us free, right? Now they want to charge money to get in, watch these big kids play. They put them in uniform. Mm-hmm. Then you got to pay for gas. Mm-hmm. Then you got to pay because, you know, we like to eat and everything. Mm-hmm. So the weekend is getting kind of out of control. So he gets in the game and want to play silly. Like he can't play. So now he got the people saying, yeah, Jay, you can only. Now, Jay. And I'm at the gym every day with Jay, saying, Jay, if you want to make it to the NBA, you got to at least shoot 1,000 jumpers a day. 1,000, you hit 10 in the game. I said, Jay, you got to practice and make perfect. So, do you want to get better? No, Dad. I go to the gym, I shoot. That's why I'm able to shoot the way I shoot. I go to the gym, I practice and make perfect. You work out, right? So watch this. Enough of y'all no more. We traveling all over. You supposed to be big dog on the campus. We traveling all over, come to the game, right? He dressed up, oh, you ought to see him. He got his band on with knees all wrapped up. Look good. Get in the game. Can't hit the side of the backboard. Fall on the floor. Now, you know the first person the people gonna look at when your kids fail you? Parents. That's your boy. Referee know he run down the bleach like. The boy done fell down again. I know that, man. I know that. Hold up. Time out. I want to call time out with the coach. So he gets outside. The coach says, yeah, Jay, you only good for three. Three shots? That's three. In case you don't want to pull you out. Pull him out, and I didn't pay him to come down here and watch him play. I got a problem with that. So I said, well, okay, Jay. I said, it's on you. You right, Jay. You messing up. So we go to lunch. I get to Waterbury. Oh, he looking at the menu. He up there looking at it. Like he didn't just won NBA championship. Like he just, he big dog. I said, son, you might want to downsize today. Because we don't have a conversation at this table. You ain't going to get that double hamburger and go out there and grease it like you're going to fall out.
Get to that little chicken thing right there. Get a couple of chips. But we went out in the spirit. We went out with conversation. I said, "Al, you did." I said, "You're too real. Are you?"
Yeah.
That's too real. We work hard. We strive. We lose, you know, but we just don't lay down. I said, "Man, they asked you to come to this team. You was a superstar. You looking like they got you on the bench. You over there looking like you ain't nothing." I said, I said, basically, Jay, I'm being honest with you. I can't afford to fill my tank up and come to White's bed. I can't do it. Because we can go to the gym and play for 2 hours and come home. I ain't got no gas. So I said, "Son, do me a favor. Go out there and have fun, but I need you to show what you can do." That's all I say. I'm not saying do it for me. But yeah, I know you can play better than me. I believe me, I'll follow you all over the world. But just go out there and do what you know you can do. Jay goes to the game. Jay gets in the game. Now, Jay didn't tell me this until after the game. Jay said he prayed. And he asked God for faith. He didn't tell me this until after. Because I was like, "Man, somebody was praying for him." Because I didn't go back and pray for him. I just said, "Lord, let him just figure it out." I really didn't. I didn't go back to the Lord, bless my son. I didn't do that. This boy goes back to his game. Jay played like the Jay of old. Did he, baby? Mm-hmm. Something went off in him. I mean, it's like something. And I was sitting there, and I just couldn't believe it. I was like, "Man, maybe I need to have some more talk." Like, I mean, dude, he went off. Off. Like everything. Shooting, crossing, layup. Ain't missed no free throw. So after the game, the coach walked outside. Now this is what contentment does for you. The enemy can say what they want all about you. But when you know that you are blessed and who you're supposed to be, don't you let nobody ever take that from you.
Amen.
Mother or father, nobody. You have to first have confidence in yourself. His confidence built up. He played the game. Now this is the same dude. An hour ago, they were saying you only supposed to shoot three. After the game, it was like, we wouldn't have won the game if it wasn't for you. How quick does your character and your attitude can change your situation? You see that? A lot of us are struggling because our character, we don't have confidence in Christ. He prayed, "God, I'm failing. I need you to help me." So this week, what I want you to do, if you are failing in something, if you are having a situation that you're struggling with, go to God. Say, "God, you made me. You created me. Build my confidence up. God, I can't." Don't trust your flesh, because your flesh will lie to you.
Yeah.
Put your confidence in God and say, "God, I need you to help me. Still need you. God, I need you to strengthen." That's what Paul said. Paul said, "I've learned that I didn't have anything." Now, you see what I'm saying? Y'all got the story? I didn't have none. So all the stuff that I have in my life, God, you gave it to. Or maybe I got it on my own, but God, teach me how to deal with this, what I gain. That I won't be gaining it. And stress is not a God. God don't want you to be stressed, saint. That's not God.
That's right.
That, saint, I'm telling you, but I don't tell you nothing else. Stress is not of God. It's of the enemy. But ask yourself, how did I get this stress in my life? Did you bring it in? Did you gain it in? Did you accept it in? Pray with me. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you for everything that we call ourselves gaining in this world. We thank you for the things you blessed us with. We know the reason why we can't close the closet door, because we know the shop. We know that, God.
Yeah.
We ask you for a bigger closet. We ain't going to do nothing but put more clothes in it. Sometimes, God, instead of asking you for a bigger closet, we need to ask you to show us how to take care of the ones we got. Father, teach us how to be content. God, we thank you for the cereal that is in the house.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We don't go in the store and get so desperate that we're going to steal the Fruit Loops. Mm-hmm. We're going to wait till we get the money to afford it. Somebody right now, the devil telling them to go steal a box of Fruit Loops because they want some. No. Wait, godliness, contentment.
Yes, yes.
God, don't let the people, God, make a disgrace of you. Give us patience, strength. Oh,
heart and with your hands. Long suffering, meekness. There's no law for such things. God, put these things in our spirit this week. That before we go off, let us think about what the consequence is going to be.
Yes, Lord.
Father, build us up where we've been torn down. Help us where we failed. Father, I thank you for Paul and showing Timothy that there's nothing that we brought in this world. We're not going to carry anything out when we go. So today, all the things that is troubling the people of God in this room, let them ask themselves, God, if I was standing before you today, would this stop me? Would this hinder me from getting into heaven? Would this be a hindrance for me receiving the things that you have for me? And Father, those of you going to bless and do tremendous blessing for them, let them know, God, that later on in Scripture, Paul talk about it's not money, but the love of money is the root of all evil. So if we get gain, if we get a blessing, let us not be foolishness with it, but let us be good steward over it. Bless everybody who came out today. Thank you for this message. Thank you for this word.
Yes.
And we're going to put our confidence back in you. Repeat after me, say, Father.
Father.
Help me.
Help me.
To trust you.
To trust you.
And not myself.
And not myself.
Let me not, Father.
Let me not.
Lean into my own understanding.
Lean into my own understanding.
But in all thy ways.
But in all thy ways.
Acknowledge you.
Acknowledge you.
And you're going to direct my path.
You're going
to direct. Come on, give them a hand of praise for doing it. Father, we thank you today. We ask that you would bless as we get ready to take up our offer. We thank you for this message today, God. Confidence in you will build true character in the midst of crisis. So, God, we're not worried about the crisis that's coming our way. We're worried about the character that is going to be built in the midst of this. And that if we have you, you're going to show us how to be able to perform and be able to deal with the things that come our way. We ask this in your precious Son, Jesus' name. Amen. And we ask some of the